Here, the 20 biggest referee mistakes in football history.
Penalty! Oh, that was a hand.
And Scarron is back! Oh my goodness!
And let's start with this one from 2005. The score is 0-0 between Manchester United and Tottenham, and United's goalkeeper makes a mistake and plays the ball to the other team. And Pedro Mendes just hits the ball. What a goalkeeper mistake. But the biggest blunder was made by the referee. The ball was well behind the line, but he didn't see it. The goal didn't count and the game ended in a draw. What a mistake, but nothing compared to what is coming. For example, a mistake that made a whole nation cry.
Here's Totti.
But also, our number 19 is a legendary moment, which in the end helped decide the Premier League Championship. In the 1970-71 season, Leeds United was competing for the title, but things really went wrong in the game against West Brom. West Brom took the ball and the assistant referee raises the flag. Everyone stopped because they thought it was offside. But the referee waved to play on and the goal counted. The assistant referee thought the ball was going to this player and raised the flag. And this made everyone unsure of what's happening. No wonder the players were upset. Leeds ended up losing the title race to Arsenal, but they won the league 2 years later. And hey, exactly for this reason, you know, to avoid such mistakes, the VAR, the video assistant, was introduced. But even he seems to have forgotten his glasses sometimes. In 2022, Everton was fighting to stay in the league, and the upcoming match was against title contender Manchester City. We are at the end of the game, City is 1-0 ahead.
Chance here, Richarlison blocked by Ederson. Oh, that was the hand.
Rodri plays the ball with his arm and the VAR intervenes and doesn't decide for a penalty. Everyone was confused. How can this not be a handball? And Everton, they were very angry.
I've got a 3-year-old daughter at home who could tell you that's a penalty.
And Hoffenheim was too, because the referee missed something pretty important in this game. A hole in the goal net. Stefan Kiesling's header counted. But how about our next pretty funny mistake? Chelsea was already 2-0 ahead against Arsenal, and suddenly they reappeared in front of the goal.
And he's teed up Hazard! Oh, it was almost three!
Hazard shoots at the goal, the Arsenal player fends it off with his hand, it's a clear foul and a red card. The referee did everything right, except for one important thing. He showed Kieran Gibbs the red card, but it was Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain who made the save with his hands. He pointed this out to the referee, hey, this was me, ref. But that didn't help. Gibbs had to leave the pitch, and Ox was allowed to continue playing. In the end, Arsenal went down 0-6, and the referee, yeah, he went down in history for this decision. You could almost think that he took a few too many sips the night before, and what sounds too funny to be true actually happened. In a Bundesliga match in 1975 between Werder Bremen and Hannover, referee Wolf-Dieter Arnfelder blew the whistle for halftime, after just 32 minutes had been played. The assistant referee pointed out to him that it was still too early, and the game continued. But then he blew the whistle too early again, in the 43rd minute. In hindsight, he admitted to have had a few beers and schnapps before the game. And his comment about all of this, we are men and don't drink Fanta. What a referee. The Zambian referee Jenny Sikazwe also blew his whistle too early, but he wasn't drunk. In 2021, Mali played against Tunisia in the African Cup of Nations. We are in the 85th minute. Yes, just like Arnfelder, the referee ended the game early. Tunisia was 0-1 behind and the coach was visibly angry. The game continued, but after a while...
Hakam.
In the 89th minute, the referee ended the whole thing too early again and hell broke loose. The referee committee later apologized and they said the referee had a heat stroke and hadn't been drinking enough water and hence lost concentration. We are in Turkey and yes, that leak gave us some funny and heated moments. But this is probably one of the most beautiful goals ever. In September 1986, defending champion Beşiktaş played against Ankara Gücü and it was 0-0. But suddenly... a beautiful goal by the referee. And it counted. Beşiktaş couldn't believe it. And in the end, they lost the game. And Galatasaray won the Turkish league. Beşiktaş finished second with 1 point behind, but with a better goal difference. Yes, the referee literally had a say in the championship. And also, our next mistake is mind-boggling. Manchester United played against Tottenham in 2010. Ronaldo had left the club for Madrid a year earlier, and Nani was now filling in his spot. In the game, Nani comes down in the penalty area, but no penalty given. But then...
Gomez puts it down on the floor, which it obviously wasn't where the initial offense was.
Then he realizes it isn't a free kick, sticks it in
the back. Goal counted. And all of you who are now saying, well, smart play by Nani, take a closer look. He falls and then picks up the ball with his hand. There should have been a free kick for Tottenham. All players run forward and then are surprised why Nani is celebrating. But now to one of my absolute favorite goals. We stay in England. Watford played against Reading and Reading had a corner after 30 minutes. But then this. The assistant referee signaled to the referee that he had to speak to him. He had seen something that no one else had seen. A goal. And the referee, he decided to award a goal to Reading. Watford was upset. The coach was sent off for complaining. But it didn't help. Oh, what a mistake. But hey, what the English can do, the Germans can do as well. In 1994, Bayern Munich played against Nuremberg. There was a corner. Yes, everything seems normal, but then the referee decided for a goal in consultation with his assistant referee, even though Thomas Helmer shot the ball past the goal. Bayern won 2-1, but the German Football Association decided for a rematch, which Bayern easily won 5-0. And also our number 9 was driving people crazy, except for the Germans. They were probably pretty happy about this referee mistake. World Cup 2010 in South Africa. We are in the knockout stage and there was a big game ahead. England versus Germany. Germany scored 2 goals, but Upson also scored one. Then Lampard takes the stage.
That's a lovely touch. Lampard!
What a shot. The England manager celebrated, but the referee said no goal. And yes, this looks a bit like the Wembley goal, even though there are still discussions as to whether the ball there was actually behind the line or not. We don't need to discuss stuff here. You can clearly see it. The ball was not behind the goal line. But our next referee performance, yeah, it was very dubious. And some don't even speak of mistakes. They say the referee deliberately made the wrong decisions. World Cup 2002 in South Korea and Japan. And South Korea surprised everyone with the help of the referees. 16 teams are left in the tournament and South Korea faced Italy. A great team with superstars like Totti, Buffon and Maldini. But already after 3 minutes, there was the first questionable decision.
Penalty!
Penalty for South Korea after this moment. Yeah, I don't really think that was a foul if you ask me.
And Chung-Kwan is a brilliant save.
Overtime, Totti fell down in the penalty area.
Here's Totti.
The referee actually gave a red card to Totti because of diving, even though this is clearly a foul. In addition, a regular goal was not awarded in extra time due to offside. And then it happened. Of course, South Korea scored the golden goal and kicked Italy out of the tournament. The referee Byron Moreno attracted attention again in 2010. He was arrested in New York. He wanted to smuggle drugs into the country. And also our number 7 made a whole nation cry. We are in the qualifying games for the 2010 World Cup. And one of the games was France versus Ireland. France won the first leg 1-0, but in the second leg, Ireland fought and scored a goal. Extra time. Everything looked like a sensation. Would Ireland beat France? But in the 103rd minute, this happened. Henri touched the ball with his hand twice and then passed the ball to Gala. The referee team didn't see it. And okay, I mean, all this happened so quickly, but the hands were also involved in this next moment. But I don't know how anyone could miss that one. We are at the 2011 Women's World Cup. Equatorial Guinea played against Australia.
Off the post, Kermis with the uppercut.
The ball hits the post and then the player catches the ball, runs a little with it and then drops it. And the referee says, play on. The Australians and everyone else look puzzled. How can you not give a penalty for that? And you know who else was puzzled? Nigeria, during the Africa Cup 2000. After a nerve-wracking tournament with beautiful goals, Nigeria and Cameroon made it to the final. In regular time, both teams scored 2 goals each. And extra time didn't give us a winner, penalty shootout.
And Aliou waits again.
The referee says no goal, but the slow motion clearly shows that the ball was behind the goal line. The assistant referee stood right at the goal and did see it, and Nigeria lost the final. But that's nothing compared to our number 4. In 1993, Dundee United played Partick Thistle in the Scottish Premiership. There was a corner. What had happened? The player Paddy Connolly shot the ball into the goal and it bounced back off the backside of the goal. A Partick Thistle player then caught the ball and then dropped it to the goalkeeper, and the referee saw nothing of this. The goal was not awarded and also no foul for handball. I mean, this is not just one but two mistakes, and how can you not see either one of them? It's understandable that Dundee United was very upset, but the referee didn't care. And we're already in our top three. Here it gets really funny. How about this mistake during the Duisburg versus FSV Frankfurt game?
Dann kommt Tiffert und jetzt aufgepasst. Kein Tor.
Yes, clearly no goal. But the referee blew the whistle and runs to the center of the pitch. He actually awarded the goal. The goalie couldn't believe it, and Duisburg was smiling. The ball is over 1 meter away from the goal line. Yeah, one of the most bizarre goals that actually wasn't a goal. And our number two is also a bizarre moment. World Cup 2006 in Germany. And in the group match Australia versus Croatia, this happened. There's a foul by Croatian Simunic and he gets a yellow card. And then later, another foul and another yellow card for Simunic. But the referee didn't notice that this was his second and he just continued playing. But after the third, it was over. He got a red card. And I don't even know what Simunic is complaining about here. Probably because you haven't subscribed yet. And now to our number one, one of the most legendary goals ever. At the 1986 World Cup in Mexico, England faced Argentina and superstar Maradona in the quarterfinal. And Maradona scored with his hand. The referee thought it was a header and Maradona called it the hand of God. But have you ever wondered what the hobbies of football players are? Like, this player has a pig as a pet. Click here to find out more.